Now I will show you how to use this BMS or Barangay Management System. Okay, let's start. Just double click. Then I will type my name, Kamayoko. Admin, password admin. I already enter Barangay officials, then we can edit this one here. We can add and we can edit the existing. Just select, then double click. You can type also to search, let's say Josefina, then double click. These are the details. This is very important for my position. And this one, rank and status. We should put active for the active officials. The purpose of this rank one is here in our dashboard. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's why here it's showing rank 1 and other information. Are you clear? Now all of these officials. Here you can add resident, just click this one, then put some details here, contacts, this one also for Barangay clearance, and this one for attachment. I will show you the sample data. This one, just double click this one. This is my file here, other information, and this Barangay clearance. As you can see here, view clearance. This one, if we will click this one, look, this Barangay clearance. This one, clearance lead issue. This one, you should put this one details in order to view this entries. And also here, just click, then residence date issue is the one also. So whatever resident selected, automatically the current certificate will show based on the selected resident here. Here also certification, and these are the entries we will view. Look here. And you can click this one, automatically it will save to the desktop the PDF file here. And here you can add attachment by double clicking, then browse. Let's see here, we'll copy, we'll put here to save. Look, as you can see, if we will put here empty, it's disabled, and also deletion. But if you select here, automatically you can open, and also you can delete. Look, you can open Barangay clearance here, certification. Also here, later you can add new incident, and of course the status. We'll open this sample here. This is the very important data here. Here, this one, because whatever entries here for reporting, it will show for the incident record transaction receipt here. Address of reporting person. Here also narrative. This is a type of incident. Date time. This will automatically whatever you entries here. Date and time incident. Automatically it will extract here. Narrative. This one. And this is the place of incident showing also here. Then you can print the receipt, this one. Print and sign into the report. You can convert also to PDF. Here, incident report, this one. Look, this is the receipt, whatever, who is person, if they need. By the way, this is pattern of our PNP standard incident report here. Victim and any details. And this one, this is very important, data status. Whatever use status here, it's shown in our here. Then other case records. So this is the case records. You can give after you fill this one complete. This one, this is read. This is the very important for the summary. Look, this is the summary which you give to the subject person. So whatever entries here, it coming. Look, summary of the body. This one. So you can convert to PDF also. And you can attach the documents. Then new, to add new. This one also, resolution list. This is the resolutions. You can new resolutions record. Then this is the record existing. Resolution number 2158. Series of 2020, session D, author, who's the counselor, and this is forwarded to provincial governor's office. Resolution literacies, let's say requesting heavy equipment for farm to market. Farm to market or construction, then attach here. Then officials report, you can print registered voters here by gender. You can save by PDF or Excel or print. And also here voters list here, and you can save also by Excel and PDF settings. You can this one to add users, create new user, automatically it will open. And also user account, this is the one, user account, change user account. This one, admin, you can modify, change name, password, or account type, either admin, this one, then done. Then here also, background. And you can also modify the Barangay profile, official name Barangay Antiporo, or whatever you interest here, it will show in your reports. Automatically it will register in your reports. No need to type municipality, it automatically report generate municipality of Marihatag. Just only enter the specific province, municipality, barangay. And of course, you can upload your logo here. Okay, save. And if you close, automatically it will update your logo here. So this is it. This one, total population, registered voters, and here, male and female. So this is how to use, and also you can see the about for the system, Barangay Management System, and those are the functionalities and purposes of this database. Look, it's showing a transparent form. This is transparent form. I will attach this database and you can use before August 15, 2020. Just email me if you need some concern. Thank you and God bless.